time for another real action. Woo! So as always, we have Gilad Paz.
Hello.
And me, Natalia. And I'm so happy to be here today because today, this episode is going to be a little different because as always, I give Gilad to watch and react.
She surprises me with videos.
Yes, to react to a video that he never seen. But this time, we're going to flip the roles and I'm going to watch and react to something that Gilad chose.
So, she always chooses the singers that she liked. And she said, hey!
I didn't say I didn't like do... everyone.
No, but let's do somebody that you like.
Okay.
I'm like, okay, so we'll do this. And I got my wonderful wife, Lisa, to actually choose this one because I wanted... So this is my favorite, my all-time favorite singer and performer, bar none. And I didn't want to watch the video. I wanted it to be a real action. So I let her choose... I let Lisa choose the video for us to watch.
Oh, okay.
So it is Somebody to Love. I know that. And it's from a big performance in Toronto, I think, or something.
What year was that?
82.
82?
So this is like the height of Queen's like success. I mean, they were out for about 8 years at that point. Like really, really like one of the biggest bands in the world. So this is exciting for me to watch too. So let's
Whoa, I'm excited. And if you guys didn't watch our previous real action to Dimash, who actually performed one of Queen's cover, you should definitely hit the click below. To click the link below so you can watch it. And before we start, I just want to remind you to like and subscribe. Because we're gonna react to another one and every week and single week, so you get a notification. And also, I have a special surprise for my viewers here in YouTube. If you guys interested to be part of my 7-day challenge where you transform your voice, no matter if you're a beginner or advanced or intermediate, doesn't matter. I just want you to click the link below as well. You're gonna see a link there. You're just gonna click it. You're gonna answer a few questions and I will send you a 15-minute MP3 and a PDF that goes along with that. So nice. I'm very excited for that. And let's start with Queen.
Okay.
Oh my
let's
God.
See Queen.
Freddy. Oh my God.
Can
it's horrible.
You find me somebody?
He's just improvising.
Somebody
speaks to your heart, huh?
Somebody.
Like nothing.
That's what I'm talking about.
Somebody to
love. Nice.
Wow, beautiful, natural vibrato on the top.
Did you see the
ring? Somebody to love.
Yes. I do see the vein popping out.
Are you ready?
But it's even in the lows.
You ready, brothers and sisters?
We're ready.
Woo! Each morning I get up at time. Somebody, 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 somebody works hard every day. Try and I try and I try. But everybody wants to put me down. They say I'm going crazy. This is a lot of money in my brain. I got no common sense. I got nobody left to believe. Yeah, 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 yeah.
It's all the amazing Brian May plays. That's the choices that I talk about. Sustain a full show, there's no way they could go to the height with reaching the way you wanted to, so you let go. Which is a choice, which I respect.
That's the best part. Oh my god. Yeah. Oh my god, Freddy. Why are you gone? Why are you gone? Why are you gone? Why the best? I was tragically gone.
Yeah. So, do you want to start?
Honestly, I can't even say anything. It's just anything I will say, just not gonna represent. I think his energy, he's such a spirit, like it's a once in a generation,
yeah.
You know what I mean? It's just like, he's so colorful and so artistic and so deep and so meaningful and so everything in one person. It's just like, unbelievable, and the music is good. I know he writes his music, right? So it's like, you really can see it's coming from his gut, and I love how he, as you said, control the stage. Like, nobody can be there, like the drums, who cares? As long as Freddie's there and there's a piano and there's a mic, he will make sure you're gonna have a good time. And it's just like, I can't even say anything.
I said, number one performer, vocalist, as far as I'm concerned. I mean, he just had it. The way that he has the audience in the palm of his hand, they are just
captivated.
They are just sucking up everything that he just throws at them.
So true.
The way that he stands on a stage, like he gets up from that piano and he stands there. And it just, I'm telling you, I always, whenever I see a video of Freddie Mercury perform, it feels like he was 10 feet tall. Because he just stands there and he commands it.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, he just knows where everything is on the stage.
Right.
And he just kind of feels it. And he's
smooth also, the transitions.
Right. And he looks at the audience and he looks at the different parts of everybody in that stadium felt like he was singing to them. And that what makes an amazing performer. Now, let's talk about the things that he actually does vocally, too. So, first of all, as we know, singing sitting down is difficult. And for what he is able to do, it's pretty amazing. Now, of course, we see there is strain there. It's obvious. He is, again, and also for being a very active performer, he actually keeps his pitch very on point.
Right.
For moving as much as he's moving,
that's
and for
true.
Using his breath as much as he's using
right.
to run around,
right.
he doesn't lose breath as
his
much.
His stamina is definitely phenomenal.
Yes.
I definitely see if we were talked about the strain and also the fact that he's sitting down. One of the things that I learned as far as when I was in an Alex Ayer technique workshop is really the connection, if we can implement a little bit of vocal technique here, is the connection and the importance of the connection between the head and the spine and how important it is to not do this every time. And I saw that a lot, and specifically because we saw the angle that really kind of strained, and it can feel like everything here is strained. And that's something I feel like also his color is so unique. His color of his voice is so unique, and that raspiness I felt, that was a definitely strain, but it works. I mean, it just works, and this is his choice. And also, you need to understand, the style is a different style. It's a rock, it's raw, it definitely needs that, but it's a supported.
And it's interesting that you mentioned the rawness of the sound, of the rock sound, but with Freddie, it was always really pure.
Mm.
Because again, he came from that classical upbringing, he loved opera. And that,
yes, you can hear those.
So he doesn't do like the weird raspiness that
mm-hmm.
comes with a lot of these rock singers. He's a very straight kind of a pure kind of singer.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I love the nuance. We talk about choices and we talk about nuance a
right.
lot. He has the nuance, like when he sits down again and plays, and all of a sudden he goes to a little bit of a softer place.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
And remember, so if you go to our first ever real action video, that was Adam Lambert singing Somebody to Love.
Aha!
So go back to that and let's talk and see how we talk about that and when we talk about here. And I remember liking Adam doing his own thing.
Mm-hmm.
So That's great, but notice how we also discussed the little lack of nuance that I felt, and I think that Freddie really just knew. Again, I think there's something about to do with his classical training, to be able to bring in a little bit of nuance.
Yes.
That's a little bit more classical.
And a little more softer, although it's raw, but it's still soft at the same time. And
I think that's a classical thing. I think so.
I think that background influence is definitely something you can definitely hear. Wow.
Freddie Mercury. Wow.
That's so.
And now you know, every time I react, now you know what the type of singers are that I kind of base my singing on, what I grew up listening to, and what my kind of level that I'm looking for. And this, for me,
honestly,
is it's a hard...
You can't compare apples to pears, but absolutely, when you have somebody that you can look up to and really look as an idol. And I think back in the days, guys, I mean, every singer that was up there really was worthwhile watching. And I feel that's something... And I'm just not putting down nobody now and nowadays, but I feel the level of mastery and artistry and musicianship and all the things that make a great singer is definitely there, and we can learn so much about it. And just a little disclaimer, just so people know, Gilad is not a vocal coach. He's not a vocal coach. He's an amazing performer and is opera singer and crossover singer and also rock singer. So his reaction is a singer, and that's something completely different. And the way he understands vocal technique is from his understanding and his way of singing. I come from a different, completely different background as well, but I am singing not a rock, but I'm singing opera and crossover. But my thing is definitely a more pedagogical
approach.
So people just maybe got a little confused. I just want to put it out there so people understand. Okay, so I'm still recovering, but guys, we're gonna leave you with that.
Subscribe.
Exactly, like and subscribe.
Share if you like the video, share it on social media.
Absolutely, share it on Facebook and, you know, all the social media platforms. We would love and appreciate your love and support. And also, guys, if you want us to react to some of your suggestions or singers you want us to look at, please feel free to email them below for me or comment them below. And as always, guys, we thank you so much for watching us, and thank you for your support and love. And we'll definitely see us and you, hopefully, in our next video next week. So, bye!